Right, so after you've downloaded the iDatabase to your system, you go ahead to install it. For me, it's in my Finders. It should be under Downloads here. Just say iDatabase.zip. So go ahead to right click and then click on Open. It unzips and then there it is. Okay, it's unzipped, so go ahead to run it. It tells you it's an application downloaded. Are you sure you want to open it? Yes, I want to open it. And then, there. Actually, iDatabase, we have a 30 days of evaluation time. So it's a full featured version that you can use for 30 days and then you'll be able to buy if you want. So now let's go ahead to say not yet, so that we'll be able to use it as we want for 30 days. But for now, for these demonstration purposes, we are going to use it to do our work. So delete this. I was working on this before now. All right, so this is how the window for iDatabase looks like. So the next thing you want to do is to just go ahead to save file and say new database. Okay, so for new database, you have different options you can select from. You have accounts, you have books, city collections, classes, blah, blah, blah. But for now, we want to start from a blank database so that we'll see exactly how it works. So just go ahead to say none. All right, so go ahead to say, okay, so click on OK, it comes out here. So you give your database a name. For me, I'm going to call it Students DB. So just follow along and you find out it's very easy. So go ahead to double click to open Students DB. So being able to create the database called StudentDB. If you look at the screen, it tells us welcome to database StudentDB. Use plus sign to add records. If you want to modify database fields, you can. So, right. So what we are going to do now is to actually the way iDatabase handle databases is a little different from the conventional database. So actually this is a kind of NoSQL database. Let me not go into this, but so we have this StudentDB is actually a collection. So let's define our fields. So the first field, let's call it first name. Meanwhile, take note that this is what I want us to build. We are trying to build this database in iDatabase. So go ahead to take first name. So to create another field, just drag the kind of field or the field type you want to use straight to the canvas here. So for me, the first one, we have the first name. We also need another small test field, drag and drop. And we call it last name. Okay. We do need date of birth, department, and time in. Okay. So the next one is date of birth, should be a date field as you can see. So drag and drop and call it dates of birth. Okay, so it prompts whether to show now button or not. Maybe let's leave it that way. So we have department. Let's look at the table again. Department is a small test field, and then we drag and drop, and that is department. All right, so just fine. The next thing is a time in. All right, so this should be a time field. Just drag it and drop it there, and then we call it a time in. Show now button. We can leave it that way, and then we go to click on done. Okay, so now I've defined my fields, and I've also defined the table. So to add a record, just go ahead to say this plus sign. So as it is now, you need to change the view to this. Okay, change the view to a form view so that you'll be able to add data. Alright, so let's go ahead to add the first data. To add the first data, just click beside each of the levels. So for instance, the first name level, click here, and then Kainson Munanye. So this is interesting thing, it displays the datetime picker if you have used ASP.NET. So just go down all the way to the year. Okay, I'm sure you understand the point. Departments, you have computer science. Alright, so timing is also interesting. Let's go and leave it at now. And then we have created and modified. So we've added one record. Let's just add one more record or two. So saffron, another day, date of birth. Let's leave this as it is. Okay, choose this and then. So now you see the fields arranged here. Okay. So that is just good. So now if you click on the datasheet view, you find out it arranges this way. But then you want to drag this all the way so that you'll be able to see everything. So this is how iDatabase works in Mac. I hope you enjoyed it. But before I close this, I would like to tell you to click on the next video, and that should be part 2. We are going to teach you how to add images, maybe photos of users or links to your database to link to other documents related to that record. For now, my name is Kainton. I'd like to thank you for viewing, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more interesting videos.